Somebody over there! Who's there?
That voice. Marie-chan, we've been looking for you. What's with that getup? Something wrong?
Stay back.
That's right, Marie-chan. We're all here to take you back home. Come on, let's go, okay?
I have no home. You don't get it.
Dude, that eye.
I can't believe it. Why'd you come? Why?
Marie-chan, listen. We don't know what memories have come back to you or how bad they are. But nothing good's gonna happen if you lock yourself away in here.
We know we're being meddlesome, but we want to help you.
Meddlesome. That's one word for it. You thought I was in danger, didn't you? That I might get killed by the shadows. It'd be better that way. This is a grave. My grave. I'm going to die here.
Yeah, Senpai's right. We won't let that happen to you.
Shut up! You don't know anything!
Emmy-chan!
Emmy, Marie, neither of those is my name. I remember. I remember everything. My real name is Kasumi no Okami. You guys fought Kunino Sagiri and Amino Sagiri, right? I'm the same as them. I'm your enemy, one of the ones who covered your town with fog.
Marie-chan is our enemy?
No way!
You serious? Kunino Sagiri and Amino Sagiri were those...
I remember them too! They're those guys that came out from Adachi Baby and that Namatame guy!
That's what you remember?
That's right. Sneaking into the human world. Sensing the will of man. My role was to inform the Sagiri what the wish of the people was. That's why I'm the only one of them that looks human. Even without my memory, my body fulfilled my role. In your words, I'm a spy.
You were spying without knowing it? That's so cruel.
Do you understand now? Plus, I'll tell you something good. If I don't die, then your world will disappear. So, don't come chasing me.
Marie-chan!
Our world will disappear.
What does she mean by that? We know that she's one of those monsters, like the ones that came from within Adachi-san and Namatame. She may have a valid reason for shutting herself in this area.
Now's not the time for deduction! She is trying to kill herself! We can't leave her like this!
Yes. Either way, we cannot leave her be. Let us hurry.
There she is! Marie-chan!
Why? Why do you come? Why? I told you I'm your enemy. That you don't need to bother with me. Why did you come this far? Thank you. It won't do you any good. I'm tired. I just want to end it all.
Shut up, you know what that means. You think we're just gonna lie down and let you do that?
Marie-san, please listen. Even if you are one of those creatures, that's still no reason for you to end your own life. The two Sagiri have been defeated. That means you're...
free? Is that what you think? That's not true. I'm not like you. I don't have freedom. I told you already. If I don't die, then your world will disappear. Our role was more than to simply find out the wishes of man. Our true role is to control the fog and bring that wish to fruition.
Control the fog?
Don't you think it's strange that the fog never went away? That it lasted for months? The Sagiri created the fog, and I absorbed it. The fog that changes people to shadows.
Wait, then the reason the fog cleared was...
That's right. When Amino Sagiri was defeated, the fog covering your town was no longer needed. Then I heard a voice. And all the fog flowed into me. The fog isn't gone. Even now, it's raging inside me.
No way. So the fog isn't gone after all that. It's just in you now?
When my mind is completely overpowered by the fog, I will disappear. Taking the fog and the hollow forest with me, I am a being destined for non-existence.
What's wrong?
That's right. There is no need for the truth. Ignorance is bliss. There will be no pain if you never try to find out.
That voice! That's not Marie-chan!
Is that what she meant by her mind being overpowered? Hey! Snap out of it!
Don't come near me! Go home! Please, just go home! All you losers! You just don't know when to quit! I never should have met any of you! Especially you! I hate you!
Yeah, what he said! You really aren't true to yourself, are you? You need to work on your acting skills!
Stop lying to me!
It's not a lie!
Everything in this world is the product of someone's mind. This place is yours. This tomb, and the flowers all over it. Your resolve to die is what created this scenery. However, on the way here we saw things that don't fit a grave. Juness and Sozai Daigaku signs, the bench on the hill, the electric poles, mirrors, school desks. It's all from the town, the home of the people you say you hate so much.
What, you want us to bury you with all that stuff? If you like them that much, why don't you come see for yourself, huh?
I can't. I have to die. Another way?
Yeah, he's right. You don't have to go away forever. The only thing that needs to go is your fog.
It's impossible. There's no way. If we waste any more time, the fog will take me over and be set free. If that happens, I won't be able to take my own life. I'll become a monster.
Are you saying we should wait for Marie-chan to be controlled by the fog and then defeat her? Senpai, wait! I mean, it's still her body, right? If we fight the monster...
Yeah. So what'll happen?
I don't know. But maybe right now. You might be able to. I'll put my mind to sleep before the fog overpowers it. Of course, the fog will then take over my body, but my mind will still be safe beneath it. The rest comes down to luck, I guess. Which will give out first? The fog? Or my life?
That's one hell of a gamble. What are we gonna do?
I'd rather not have to do that. But if there's no other way, then we'll just have to have faith that it'll work.
Yeah, it's gotta be better than just sitting here and watching her die.
She's not gonna die! We won't let her! This is our friend's life on the line! We can't fail now!
Friends... trust in you all, even if I do die. It would be a better way than letting the current situation continue. But please, don't any of you die.
It's coming! Get ready, everyone!
Will this really work? Emmy-chan won't die if we fight her?
Marie-chan believed in us. We have to believe in her.
All right. Right. Yeah.
Don't be cautious. Don't be kind. You committed. I'm your crime. Push my button. Anytime you got your finger on the trigger, but your trigger finger's mine. Silver dollar, golden flame. Dirty water, poison rain. Perfect murder, take your aim. I don't belong to anyone, but everybody knows my name. Why the way you've been uninvited?
Did we do it?
How is she, Senpai? She okay?
No way. This can't be real.
No, this can't be. We...
Emmy-chan? Come on. You're such a sleepyhead. It's time to wake up, okay? Emmy-chan? No! This isn't happening! What did we do wrong? Emmy-chan, wake up! Don't die!
Get off of me! Marie-chan? Thank goodness she's alive! Oh! That's right.
Everyone gets to sleep once in a while, right? Thank you.
You think that's long enough for a moving hug? Shouldn't you let go now?
Nope. I'm tired of moving. Enough with getting up. Good thing there's someone even I can hug.
Hey! Here we go again. Why is it all our friends are like this?
You know, there aren't a lot of people who can really mess with Risei-chan.
Did you feel the earth move? Or was that just me watching these two?
This isn't the time for stupid comments! What's going on?
Don't tell me! Is this like in the movies where once the bad guy's defeated, his evil fortress self-destructs?
I'm sorry, I forgot to mention. I don't need to be in this place to die anymore, so it's gonna disappear.
Why the hell didn't you say that sooner? It's gonna take us with it!
We're gonna die! We're all gonna die!
Just get to the exit! Hurry!
I forgot how tiny the TV here is.
I feel like this has happened before.
Are these really your friends? They're all so weird.
It's your fault to begin with!
The TV! That was never a television. The Hollow Forest has vanished because there's no more reason for it to exist.
We did it! So, how does it feel to have your fate changed?
Well, it feels weird. After all, I'm alive.
Well, yeah. That's why we went all the way there and everything.
Thank you for saving me. And I'm sorry. What? Why are you looking at me like that?
You just said sorry, didn't you?
She did, very politely.
Huh?
It's just that you never seemed like the type who would say that.
Huh? You stupid jerk! Fine then! Forget it! I take it back!
Oh well.
Listen to me! What the hell? What is with you people? You risk yourselves to save me? You don't get anything out of it! I don't understand you! Really?
To be honest, we were hesitant at first. Learning that you were from the other side was kind of confusing. But to not save you just because of that? Oh, that's not how we roll.
If we blamed things on someone else and looked the other way, nothing would change. You were in trouble and we saved you. That's all that counts.
I don't understand you at all.
If not knowing us bothers you, then you should start getting to know us. All of us want you to learn more about this world.
Yeah, like Valentine's Day.
Valentine?
Ah, so you don't know what that is either. Huh. It's an awesome day when a girl gives chocolate to someone she holds dear. Oh, and I already reserved senpai.
Whatever. No cheating. Reservation canceled.
Why, you...
That was quick. Well, let him get to it.
Hey, it's clear outside!
You're right. I need to do all the laundry.
My back is killing me. Hey, how about we get some grub?
Sounds good. On you, of course.
Oh, stop expecting me to buy you lunch all the time!
Yeah, I'm okay. Let's go. Everyone's waiting. Well, when I gave my body up to the fog, I thought I heard a voice. What did it say? Humans don't want to know the truth. What they truly desire is a peaceful world filled with fog. Something like that, anyway. I don't know. But it was familiar. The same voice I heard when you defeated Amino Sagiri and the fog flowed into me. Wait. Maybe not. I felt like it was my voice. Maybe it's something I said long ago? Oh well. The fog is gone. I probably just misheard it.
Scared you, huh? The weather's nice, there's snow all over. What more do we need? Oh yeah, you ever been in a snowball fight, Marie-chan? Hey, how are we gonna split the teams? Oh, what the? Hey!
I'm supposed to throw snow at him. Isn't that right? Okay, I will bury him.
Hold on! You have the eyes of a predator!
The teams will be women versus men. Now begin!
Oh, come on! Kanji, Teddy, what the hell, guys?
Take this! Get him, Marie-chan!
Why are you only going after me?
our supreme snowball skills.
Well, I do feel a bit sorry for them.
Still, today's hero's gotta be Marie-chan. You go, Snowball Queen!
That's the wrong gender. It's heroine, not hero.
Whoa! Your skin is so pretty!
Your complexion is amazing!
Yo, can you see anything?
The steam's covering all the good stuff.
Hey, Kanji, up, up! Don't let me down now!
Ted, you punk! I'm done with this!
Cut it!
You dirty pervert! Oh! Trying to peep again! Oh!
Marie-chan, electricity here is a bad idea!
Disgusting creeps!
I hate you all!
Well, what should I do now? I'm gonna hang out here for a bit longer, but I don't know what to do.
Not like there's anything for me to do at home anyway. Oh, I got it! I'll go up to the roof or something!
I'm gonna be behind the school building. You know, just because.
Most of the girls are already gone.
Hey, man, all these guys are obsessed with chocolate. They want candy so much, why don't they just buy some themselves?
Are you serious? This is the one day you shouldn't be buying chocolate for yourself.
Yeah?
Man, you're clueless. Whatever. I know I'm getting some for sure today. Part-time workers at Juness. The important thing is that I have any at all. Right, Chie-san? Yukiko-san? I see you've got some big bags with you today.
Wow, that's not the sound of desperation or anything. Yeah, I do have some. Right, Yukiko?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, sweet. I like candy.
What makes you think it's going to you? It might be for me.
Don't be so desperate. And I brought some, too.
Oh, are you guys handing out chocolate? Great timing. Here you go, Chie-senpai, for always being so hardworking.
Why me?
Because today's for giving out chocolate to the people you like, right? It's a great day to say thank you to all those people in your life, not just your romantic partner.
Wow, putting a new spin on things.
She's so thoughtful. Must be all those years in showbiz. Hey, what about him?
I'll give him his chocolate later. I've got some stuff to take care of right now, but I'll call you soon.
Does that mean...
I feel like everyone's super curious about who I'm going to hand my special chocolate to. If I do it now, it'll be embarrassing. So, see you later. Well, I have some other people to give chocolate to. Bye!
Wow, her ability to avoid personal drama is impressive.
Oh, Nato-kun!
What are you all doing together?
What's that supposed to mean? Today's a huge deal.
I see. Well, if you'll excuse me.
She never breaks a sweat. Oh well, Kanji. Guess we're spending time with each other today.
Sure, why not?
I totally feel like we missed the train here.
Attention, everyone! I have chocolates here with everyone's names on them. Please take your candy and go home. Well, I've got to go back to the inn and help out. Good luck, Chie. Yukiko?
Man, Yukiko's being even bossier than normal.
make sure she's okay. Oh, this is chocolate for everyone in it. Take yours and go home.
What the hell? Talk about being brushed off.
Well, you don't want yours? I'll take it.
God, you moron. Of course I want it.
No one can bother us here. I've got you all to myself. Just kidding. Here, this is for you. Sorry to keep you waiting. I knew you'd notice how special it is. I added durian and habanero to it. Anyone can just melt some chocolate and pour it into a mold. Where's the love in that? So I added a bit of originality. I'm certain you'll like it. What's the matter? Oh, eat it now. I worked so hard on it. I want to see your happy face. Aren't you glad, Senpai? Fine then. I forgive you. But you'll have to tell me what you think later. The only thing I can hear is the sound of the waves. It's like we're all alone in the world. I'm going to tell you my dreams. I haven't told anyone else. I want to work and go to college. I think I could study lots of things. And during all that, I want to have a serious relationship with a man I love and get married on a tropical island and live in a house with a big yard and get a big dog. I'll cook and live happily with my husband. And then when we're old, we're gonna drink tea every day by the garden, together. Just kidding. I'm such a weirdo. Hey, don't jump to any conclusions. I didn't even say who I was talking about. Senpai, by a man I love, I meant you. Right now, it's just a dream, but it's important to me. So I want to make all my dreams come true, one by one, with you at my side. Whoa, you can't take that back. Did you know, Senpai? People were born from the sea. I feel like we're Adam and Eve right now, just the two of us here. Eve was Adam's wife, so that means Adam gets to have Eve all to himself.
You're late. Oh, yeah. Today, I can't have the nose or Margaret getting in my way. Don't worry, I got permission. I have chocolate. You can have it. That room doesn't have any eclectic Lautwitz. I did the best I could, but I don't know if it turned out any good. Sorry. Oh, yeah. You're too straightforward. I hate you, stupid! That's why you're so popular. You can eat it. If you don't hurry, it'll melt. If it melts, it'll run away. When you eat it, I want you to tell me whether it was good or not. Now. You ate it all? That's incredible. Are you stupid? Well, it makes my work worth it. Valentine's Day isn't an actual ritual, huh? I looked it up. I thought it was some big event, you know, a turning point of your life. I'm so lame. I was fooled. I feel stupid. Ugh. But it's not like that. I didn't make that chocolate just because I thought it was something I was supposed to. No, that makes it sound like I'm serious. Well, I am serious, but... And you can just shut your stupid jerk face! I am calm. Look, just close your eyes. Shut up and close them. Thank you. Well, I don't really get it, but I won't forget about you. Ever.
Big bro, do you know what day it is today? How did you know? I bought it in secret. This is my favorite chocolate. It's sweet and yummy. Today, my teacher said, Valentine's Day isn't just a day to give out chocolate. It's a day to say thank you to the people you care about. Teacher gave us all chocolate, everybody, even me. And when she gave it to me, she said, it's been tough for you, but you've done very well. Everyone tells me I'm strong for pulling through. That's why I said thank you back. And I said that my big bro and my dad are rooting for me, and that's why I can be happy again. Really? And then my teacher was so happy. And then she said, when someone's cheering you on, even when you're in trouble, you feel energized. Do you feel like that when I cheer you on? Me too. When you root for me, I get so happy. We're the same. Me, my dad, and your friends are all on your side. Even if you go back soon, I hope you're happy. I had one more chocolate. I made it myself. The big girls taught me how to make homemade chocolate creations. That's why I made one for you. Chie said I should mix in iced coffee to add flavor. Oh, and bacon, since everyone likes bacon. Luckily, there was some bacon and iced coffee in the fridge. Risei-chan said that the chocolate should assert itself, so it needs to be either really sweet or really spicy. You're a grown-up, big bro, so I thought you'd appreciate a bitter taste. So I put bell peppers and wheatgrass juice in it. I think that sour chocolate sounds really assertive, so I added vinegar and ponzu sauce too. Yukiko said that my chocolate would have depth if I added fish. So I added some fish sausage and some of Dad's fermented squid. And Naoto told me she'd let me borrow a recipe book. And when I told her I was already done, she told me that you'd enjoy anything that I made for you. Big bro, thank you. I love you. What's wrong?
All done packing? Well, if you forget anything, I'll mail it to you.
Can I go answer the door?
Oh, yeah. That's right. Sure. Go answer it. There's nothing to worry about anymore. Seeing her so cheerful like that, nothing makes me happier. I already bought your train ticket for tomorrow. It leaves at 9 o'clock in the morning from Yasuida Bus Station. Today's your last day here. Don't worry about Nanako. You can leave her to me. Go see your friends. This might be your last chance to talk to them.
Are you going out? Be careful.
What a coincidence! It must be destiny!
Oh, so you guys came here too!
It's our very own special headquarters. There are so many memories here.
Yo there, Senpai. I thought you'd be here.
We had a feeling we'd run into everyone if we came here.
We were planning on seeing you off at the station tomorrow, but I was feeling too restless, so I decided to come here.
Well, since we're all here, why don't we have something to eat?
Ooh, let's have steak! Steak! And make Yosuke pay for everything!
Will you shut up about your steaks?
I really had fun in this world.
Dude, your whole existence is about fun. Well, what we've gone through wasn't all fun and games. But I gotta say, I've never felt so fulfilled in my life.
It seems we've been working on this forever, but at the same time, it felt like it went so fast. We won't ever gather here again like this, or tear our hair out trying to solve the mysteries.
Even if we wanted to talk about it all, there were so many extraordinary things that no one would believe us. Come to think of it, for me, I think it all started when Chie told me about the Midnight Channel.
I think I heard about it from her too. How did you learn about it, Chie?
I guess it was just a random rumor. A lot of girls were trying it out.
Huh. I wonder how it started then.
Who knows? Maybe someone accidentally came across it?
The Midnight Channel. You know, that really was the cause of everything. I mean, the fog lifted after we caught Adachi, but there's still a lot of stuff that isn't clear yet. It's still foggy over there, too.
Some weird guy might use it to do bad things again.
Didn't that Amino something monster say it granted us power?
I bestowed power onto those who could brave the Hollow Forest. In other words, he gave the power to enter TVs to those who awakened to their persona ability, so that he might use us as pawns to enact his scheme.
Hey, that reminds me. Didn't your hand suddenly slip into the TV even before anything happened to you? Does that mean you're an exception? Well, wait, then what about Adachi and Namatame? Those two could go inside TVs before all this stuff about personas, right?
What? Then Senpai and the other two could do it for some other reason?
There must be something you're not remembering. Anything come to your mind, Senpai?
A letter? Hey, this better not be another warning. Huh? This is from jail? It's from Adachi.
I'm sure you're surprised to get this letter out of the blue. I'm writing this because there's something I need to tell you. Ever since I made it out alive, there are some things I understand now. It's true that my game's over. As you all insisted at the time, I'll abide by the rules of this world. But as long as I'm in stir here, I can't clean up after myself. So I hope this will give you something to think about regarding this case. There's still this feeling I can't shake. It's about how it all started, about that midnight channel. Now I remember, someone told me about it when I first came to town, before I heard the rumors at the station. And I was intrigued when I noticed that something similar was written on Namatame's reports as well. But I can't remember who it was that told me. Since Namatame and I both gained our power after coming to Inaba, I've a feeling that has something to do with it. I don't know if any of this will be useful or not, but I hope it can help somehow. When I'm here, I think of Dojima-san, Nanako-chan, and you. A lot. Though my time with you didn't seem like much fun before, it's strange. Despite it all, I'm grateful to you. Thank you. But let me just say this. You're a dumbass. You take the path you choose, and I'll think about what that means to me, too. I doubt I'll ever see you again, but stay healthy. Goodbye.
It's not very helpful to know that he can't remember who it was.
I'm not sure how to put it, but I kind of know the feeling. It's like, I don't know how to say this. Like something's connecting all these things. Something beyond what we can see. That world, the midnight channel, the ability to enter TVs. They all feel like separate things. You know what I mean? First the rumors, then the serial murder, followed by us deciding to investigate the case. If they all really were separate, they wouldn't fit together like this, right? There has to be some kind of conductor behind everything.
So you think the person Adachi mentioned, the one who told him about the Midnight Channel, is that conductor? Did I strike gold again? It's seriously just something that popped into my head!
Senpai, is there anything like that you can think of? We were involved in a murder case last year, which we succeeded in solving. But the monster we fought last said we did well in playing our parts. Perhaps this means Adachi and Namatame were players as well. Could it be that from the beginning, this serial murder case was merely a portion of a much larger scheme? And none of the people who were directly involved in the case ever suspected it.
Hey, this scheme, could it be the whole thing about filling both worlds with the fog and turning mankind into shadows? So someone was behind the scenes watching us, the culprits, and maybe even that monster. And he manipulated Adachi and Namatame at the very beginning so everything would come together perfectly?
Let's go out into town. We might find something. Although, you may be the only one capable of noticing it. Please contact the rest of us should you come across anything.
We can't say our goodbyes tomorrow with this hanging over our heads. Let's go figure this out.
The day you first came to town? Let's see. We were the first ones to greet you, right? Did we stop somewhere on the way home? I'm pretty sure Nanako and I left home that afternoon, picked you up, and came straight back. Now that I think back to that night, I was called back to work as soon as we got home, so I couldn't talk much. And the very next day, those strange murders started. Sheesh. Lots happened since then. It's been one heck of a year, hasn't it?
Hey, Big Bro. On the first day, didn't we stop at that place?
Give it some thought, why don't you? We don't mind if you're a student. Oh, I should get back to work.